So what does a mobile lifestyle really mean? What's the reality? Hey, I'm John Harris, and this is the Exponential Entrepreneurs Academy, coming to you live from our home studio. Look, before I answer that, I just want to recap where we got to with our exponential lifestyle, because we're talking exponential lifestyle now. We spoke about how to structure perhaps your morning ritual in the morning and make it as productive as possible. Lunchtime, we just can think of things that are productive. So you could use it to have a lunch with and talk to somebody who may be very knowledgeable at something that's interests you, or something where you have a problem, may be able to help you with an issue. You may be able to do a recap on your planning and see how much you've done and what you need to still do and how to change your day and make it positive. You can always win the day even at the last moment. You can make it a win. In the afternoons, you may want to do something like more administration, things that you have to do that are less person-to-person direct creativity and doing something that's a little bit more mundane, but getting it out the way. I like to make late afternoon my training time, and you know, dinner is for me a family affair. Perhaps it's a time to get the family together and communicate and get to know what's bothering people within the family or so forth, and something that's positive for them. After that, you know, nighttime, I find there's patches that I could go through, and it's great to do some learning. You can get out some of your videos that are self-help videos, some of the things that you use to learn new things and train your brain. So those are some of the things we can look at with the day, with regards to the day, and trying to make it as exponential and potential as possible as far as your growth is concerned, your mind, your business, and whatever area that you're focusing on specialized knowledge. Getting back to your mobile lifestyle, and this is, we're talking lifestyle, and I went fully in. We bought a mobile camper, a 6-berth camper, and we traveled around in that, and we weren't fully in that because we do have other properties in other places. So I've been doing, you know, mobile as far as I can work out of the car, I can go to our retirement place and work there, I can work from home, I can work from the office. But working from home is not truly mobile. I think the digital nomads have it right, where they travel and they work from a destination. So the downside of a camper is this: you can get the camper and do the camping thing, but it's not easy, because understand, there's a lot of work involved. When you drive that camper, you've got to keep it running. You can't just let it sit for months on end because it deteriorates. So you need to drive the thing, which is an expense. You also need to understand that you can only, these larger ones, you can only park in certain areas. They're not easy just to go to shopping centers with. Not only that, you've got to then work to keep it clean. You've got to work to do repairs on the camper. And also the other thing that I found is that you need to do, or you don't really have the opportunity to do videoing and other things that may take a bit of a space that you need, a private space, because there's always a dog barking or somebody shouting or something going on that interrupts the video. So it's not all that is baked out to be. That's as far as camping is concerned, going around in a camper. The other thing is that, you know, it isn't just that working from home is not truly mobile, but having the opportunity to work from different places. And I will tell you this, you need to then take your office in the back of your car. So you need to cut it down to a bare minimum that you got your laptop and you got the other things that you may need. And I still kind of carry 2 briefcases, fairly large briefcases, to take my office around with me. So there is the lack of convenience is the word that I'm looking for when it comes to a mobile lifestyle. Look, I would recommend that you do have a base somewhere that you can operate out of. I still go to our main head office. I have a base there. And, you know, the home office is okay, but as I say, it's not the perfect setup. And the other thing I find with the home office is you can start to get isolated. When you're on your own and in traveling, you start to get isolated. That's why, again, I say the ZGNers have it down packed, where they go out with a group of people. They're mixing with the same sort of people, doing similar type of work, online work, and they're looking to incorporate travel at the same time. You know, those guys that are doing the YouTubing videos and going traveling the world, people that are doing graphics, that are doing Photoshop, that are working on other aspects of creative writing, scripting, and so forth, and they can do it from different locations. So that is something that is worth thinking about and getting upskilled in. The whole thing now is, obviously, we've spoken about with lifestyle, with having a mobile lifestyle. If you have enough passive income, which we've spoken about before, it's whether you got to the point of having enough passive income that it exceeds your monthly expenses, then you're out of the rat race. But it's not easy, we know that. And people are going to work towards that. And even if you achieve that, you'll find that the most productive people that are out of the rat race. They still work very, very hard. The one thing that you can do, even if you don't have a lot of talent and perhaps not a lot of skill, you can work hard. Everybody can put the hours in. But if you're looking at a lifestyle there, you have choice. It's diametrically opposed. So to have that choice of what you want to do, again, you're neither going to work to a situation where you have enough income or a business that's managed that you can be out of it and away from it and not have to be there and still earn an income, or whether you're going to have real estate where you're earning an income, or whether you're going to have a portfolio, a big enough portfolio of equities and so forth that are giving you enough income. Again, these things are not easy because you have to have a large portfolio if you're going to have enough revenue to pay for your lifestyle. So as you go along and you look at different lifestyles and you think about mobile lifestyle, you think about traveling, perhaps as a digital nomad, you think about not being tied down in one place, and you really think about how you can get to a position where you don't have to be tied 9 to 5. So these are not easy things to do, but they're well worth looking at. And with people that say there's no such thing and well, passive income is no good and so forth, let me tell you, there are a lot of people that have got to the point where they're out of the rat race. That is a point of having financial independence. Freedom, again, is a word we use loosely. And remember, you've got to have self-discipline in order to have freedom. So even if you have the opportunity to get up in the day, like I've discussed, anytime you want, get up in the morning, as late as you want, you still need to try and keep a regular type of a schedule going, because if you don't do that, you're going to get lost. And it's not going to be sustainable, because you'll start to do bad things. Okay, your body will also reject this. You need to have a system and keep to that system. And so that takes discipline. But again, I say to you, discipline comes about if you have to do things you don't want. That's when we use the word discipline. It is easier if you have a vision that you do want and a purpose that drives it. Although it's a lot of work, it's then passion and it's driven. And when you have emotion that's positive and drives you towards something, it's less of self-discipline and something that you want to achieve. There's a huge difference here. I hope you can see it, whether something is negative that you have to do as opposed to something that's positive that you want to do. Both will take effort, but the one takes effort, it feels like less effort. It doesn't feel like it's discipline. It's something that you want to do, and it makes it a lot easier. Finding out what you want in life is also not easy. Getting your true purpose is not easy. You have to dig deep. You have to sit on it and think about it constantly until you get to a level of understanding that this is your true potentials. This is perhaps where you'd like your true passions to go and to be and to evolve something that of consequence, to get a massively transformative purpose going. And those are things that are not easy to find, but you have to work at it like everything. And again, that takes some discipline. So you have to allocate time for that. So as I've said before, I hope that this has been useful. Remember to subscribe, hit the notification bell, and you can get to Facebook to get some more information on our exponential masterminds. We'll see you in the next episode.